Hi, welcome to my YouTube. These are the three most popular SKS in North America: the Russian, the Chinese, and the Yugoslavian. For years, I've been hearing that the Yugoslavian has the best quality among SKS. Now, I had Yugoslavian SKS before, but I didn't have the Russian SKS. And when I did have the Russian SKS, I didn't have the Yugoslavian SKS. So this is the first time I managed to get all three on one table. Now, before I start, I want to talk briefly about the history of the SKS. It was designed by a Russian fella named Sergei Simonov, and it was adopted in 1945 by the Soviet Union. But it didn't go into production until 1949. Unfortunately, it became obsolete by then by the AK-47. But the AK-47 had some production issue, so it continued production into 1956 or thereafter. The equipment from Tula was then transferred to China to a factory number 26. Okay, and then in 1959, the Yugoslavians start to make them. Now, by 66, the Yugoslavian decided to make something quite radical. They decided to attach a grenade launcher sleeve to the regular SKS, which means they had to modify everything from here to the front. Okay, Yugoslavia is one of two countries that heavily modified their SKS for their military. Okay, Albania is the other country. Albanian SKS had a handguard that came up to here, and they had AK-47 style cocking handle, which I'd love to have one of those. And also the magazine looked different. And now Chinese did heavily modify their SKS too, but they only did it for the civilian market, not for their own military. Okay. Now, let's talk about the quality. I'm back. Now let's talk about the individual guns. Let's start off with the Russian. This one is in pristine condition. Built in 1954, you can tell from the top cover. All the serial number matches. It is unfired. One thing that's very noticeable compared to the others are the wood. It's very smooth. There's a shellac on it, and although the buttstock area, the shellac start to tarnish a bit, but that's to be expected. After all, it is almost 70 years old, but the metal is still very shiny, and the magazine is properly blocked to 5 rounds, and you can tell it has a pin welded to the follower, which limits the 5 rounds. Now, I've seen some horrible ones that literally destroys the serial number. This serial number is still intact under the tape. Now, you can tell this is a 1954 or a later version. There's two types of receivers they made, and you can tell this is the later version because there's no step on the receiver, the trunnion, right about there where my thumb is. There's no step. If you see a step, then you know that's the early version. This is the later version receiver. And they had three different types of gas block. This, of course, the later version. And then there's the middle version, which is the triangular one. And let's see, that one, the angle one was part of 1950 to part of 1952. And then this later version is probably part of 1952 and later. And the early version is the square gas block, which is from 49 to part of 1950. Now, moving along to the Chinese. Since both of these were made by the same machinery, this is also from factory 26, which was given the machinery that built this gun. And this one unfortunately has been refurbished, so it's kind of hard to tell, you know, exactly the quality of work done to it. But I can tell it was pretty darn good. The bluing, in spite of being refurbished, is still pretty good, although the work that's done to the bayonet is not as good as the Russian. You can tell it's kind of I guess it's been refurbished too. And this is a dead giveaway that's been refurbished. The top cover, the gas tube area, is parked, and so it's not even blued. But the rest is all blued, not as shiny as the Russian. This was built in 1965 at Factory 26. And there's another dead giveaway that's been refurbished, is the two different color of wood, okay? And also this wood has no serial number, so you know that this was not the original wood. Probably this was the original wood. Okay, now the Chinese had three different versions, and it goes by according to the barrel lug. They call it a lug. This is a long barrel lug. Sometime after this, there was a shorter one, like half the length, and then eventually it just went straight to no lug at all, and it was just pinned. And they did that for economic reasons. It was obviously a lot easier to put in a pin than to do all this by a qualified machinist. Okay, then moving along to the Yugoslavian. The Yugo, the wood is a strong, hefty wood. I believe it's birch or a beech. I can't remember which one it is. But the finishing is a little kind of raw, because it's not smooth. It's basically just oiled on wood. And so you can kind of feel a little rough. It feels kind of rough. They just oiled the wood. Now the metal, this one is almost new, so I can actually compare that to the Russians. And the metal is really well machined, okay, and it's all blued in the front. But when it comes to the receiver, it all of a sudden changes to park. Okay, this was built sometime in the early 80s. There is a serial number will tell me what year it was built in, but I can't actually remember what year it was, but it was built in the early 80s. That I do know. And I forgot to tell you that the Chinese also was the magazine blocked really well too. And it's by this rivet here. You see this rivet over here? And there's a pin on this side. So it prevented the follower from going any further. So the serial number is also not destroyed. The Yugo did something similar to the Chinese, except they epoxied a plate inside. They use an epoxy and I put a plate, which stops the follower from going past five rounds. And all the serial number on this gun matches, including the buttstock. And so next, what I'm going to do is take the bolt out and show you what the internal looks like. Okay, I'm back. I've disassembled all three SKS, and why don't we start off with the carrier. In terms of the workmanship, the Russian is the top workmanship, and it's very easy to tell. Just simply, you can tell from the lightning cut on the Russian is very smooth. And the Yugoslavian is a little on the rough side. Looks like they really rushed the milling machine, while the Russian is very, very smooth. And the surface is also much smoother. And the Russian looks like they use a coarser sandpaper or sand belt. So also the caulking handle, you can tell the difference in the caulking handle of the Russians is a lot better than the Yugoslavian. Then the Chinese would be, yeah, pretty close to the Russian, but not as good as the Russian. Now, next would be the bolt. And at this point, I would say the Russian is slightly behind the Yugoslavian. And I can see a lot of milling marks, and there's less on the Yugo. But I would say generally all three are pretty close. Now, if you're wondering whether these bolts are interchangeable, yes, they are. I've tried it. I have used the Yugoslavian bolt and the Chinese bolt on the carrier, and it does work. And I've done interchange all three of them, and there's no problem. Except when the Russian, they had a different carrier. Let's see. They had a bolt that was spring, that was a spring firing pin, and that was from 49 to part of 1951, or around that area, okay? So when I said these bolts are interchangeable, I'm not talking about the spring firing pin. Okay, moving on to the top cover. You can tell that the Russians are much better internal, less milling, and the Chinese is a little bit on the coarse side. You can see there's a ridge there. There's no reason it should be there because there's none on the Russian. And the Yugoslavian, unfortunately, is a little bit worse than the Chinese. So I would say again, the Russians is better. Now, you're wondering whether are these interchangeable. They are not all interchangeable. Basically, the Chinese top cover and the Russian top cover will fit the Yugoslavian, but the Yugoslavian will not fit the Chinese and the Russian. However, now the Chinese top cover will not fit the Russian, but the Russian will fit the Chinese. So it's really weird, okay? So I've tried them all, and they're not exactly interchangeable. The only one I saw that fitted well is the Chinese fit the Yugo, Russian fit the Yugo, and the Russian fit the Chinese. So moving along onto the inside of the housing, the receiver, and you can automatically tell it's very smooth milling in the Russians. It is very good, okay? You can tell it's not a rush. The machine is going at a really good pace. Chinese is quite rough around here, but generally other places are pretty good. And the Yugoslavian is, they have a lot of milling mark. They seem to speed up the milling machine faster than I guess they figured nobody can see it on the inside. So you can obviously see the milling mark is pretty obvious in that one. Now, let me talk about the internal, the bore, okay? Now, the Russian did not come with a chrome bore till part of 1951 and newer, okay? Before that, it was non-chrome. The Chinese, obviously, when this ended production, it was chrome. Obviously, the Chinese took over in 1956. They had chrome. They had chrome bore. Except the chamber was not chrome. And that came in later. Now, I can't remember again when the period was, but most Chinese, all the Chinese SKS had chrome bore. Now, not all of them had chrome chamber. Okay. Now, the Yugo, on the other hand, none of them came with chrome bore. Apparently, that country lacked minerals to make chrome. So that is what the answer is. Now, some people say because the chamber, the bore is not chrome, the rifling is sharper and it's more accurate. I did not find it that way. I did not find because it's chrome or not chrome, the accuracy improved on that. Okay, so let's move along into the, I've also disassembled the gas system, and the two gas piston, the Russian and the Chinese, they're almost identical and they are interchangeable. And the, but these two will not fit into the Yugo. It's the bore head is a bit big. Of course, the Yugo fit into the Russian without any problem, but then, you know, it probably rattles a little bit more. So yeah, Yugo would fit into the Russian and the Chinese, but the Chinese and the Russian will not fit into the Yugo. Now, what about the gas tube? Are they interchangeable? Well, first of all, you see there's quite a distinct difference in the gas tube front end. This will not fit. Yugo will not fit the Chinese and the Russian because it's too long, okay? While the Russian and the Chinese will fit the Yugo, but it's a tad short. So I haven't found out, I haven't actually tested them out to see what the results of that would be, whether it works or not work. But anyway, it's something that you should remember. In terms of workmanship, and you can see the Chinese and the Russian blacken the gas piston. Actually, they almost look identical. The only difference is that the Russian is unfired, and so it's super shiny, while obviously I have fired the Chinese SKS, one of my favorite SKS. Now, so there you have it. Now, summarizing in terms of workmanship and the quality, I honestly would say, I mean, they're all three are pretty good. They're all pretty close, but in no way I would say the Yugo is better than the Russian. Overall, that is, you know. So therefore, I would say the Russian, in terms of quality, I from what I see, is a little bit better than the Yugo, and also a little bit better than the Chinese. After all, they were all built from the same machinery. So thank you very much for joining me, and please subscribe.